Hello, everyone. Welcome to another Friday Live. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for coming and just seeing what I'm up to these days. So many of you come back week after week, and I just want to give a big thank you to you. And welcome to everyone who's watching this on replay as well, because even though as I'm doing this now live, I know some of you will be coming in later. And you'll be watching this on replay. So thank you so much for joining me. Today we're going to spend the first part of the video or of the live stream. We're just going to be going over the entire Simon release very quickly, very briefly, just a few minutes. And then we will jump into creating something. So I'm just making sure everything's coming through. Looks like everything's good. So let's get going here. All right, so we're gonna start. Let me organize this a little bit. I've got everything kind of sectioned off. First, before we get going, some of you will notice down in the video description, there's a link to my Animal Crossing Facebook group. We'll talk about that later. If you wanna go join, you can. All right, so we're gonna start with, we're gonna go through these 4x6 stamp sets. They are so cute. All right, this first one's called Bouquet for Mom. There are coordinating dies that go with it. And you have Mama, Nana, Grandma, Grandma, Mother. Happy Mother's Day. Such a cute stamp set. Hope you guys can see all the imagery on that. I think it's so great. Once again, this is Bouquet for Mom. By the way, all of these products I'm showing are listed down in the video description. I spent so much time linking everything. This is a really big release. So it took me a while to go through and link everything. I hope you guys take advantage of those links. This one is one that I created and wrote all the messages. This is Inside Family Messages. So you are one of the biggest and brightest memories of my childhood. Thank you for always being there when I needed you. You were not only family, you are an amazing friend. Just some great messages for the inside of cards going to family. No dice with that one because it's just greetings. This one is called Sweet Garden Birds. Some nice solid images. Outline images are really big. They've been really big for a while. So to have some solids like this is awesome. So you can kind of build all of your bird images with this one. There are coordinating dies available. This one is from CZ Design. This is Sassy Mama. Love it so much. My mom can be a little sassy, and I think my husband might have to use these on his Mother's Day card for his mom. So, because he's a little sassy like that too. There are dies for this one that cut out the larger words. So there are some dies that go with this one. All right, here we go. This is Sweet Garden Blooms. Some more solid images, but there are some outlines that you can pair with them. There are dies that coordinate, and you can kind of build your own garden. I think it's so great. And distance makes the heart grow fonder. We're all having a lot of distance right now, and we'll be for a little while yet, right? All right, this one's called Sweet Garden Background, so these sort of go together. Little itty bitty flowers. Does anyone else want like a shirt with just little tiny flower patterns on it? I love it. Some small greetings down here at the bottom. Let's measure how big that stamp is. It is about 4 inches wide. It's 4x5 basically. That's basically the size of this is 4x5. So it's not gonna completely cover the entire A2 card, but it'll cover most of it. All right, these next three stamp sets all go together. This is called Front Porch. It's like the overhead view, looking down into a porch. And there are some mats here that you can place onto the porch. There is a small die set that you can get that will cut out the flower and also the mat. So you can build a porch scene. Along with that, you can have people standing on the porch. This is Front Porch Family. And there are pumpkins and plants, different things to decorate your porch as well. There's different leaves, you can make it seasonal. Lots of different feet to be included. And there are dies that you can get as well. And then on top of that, you have like this one, which is called Front Porch Doormat Sayings. You've got a nice rug right here. You've got some pets that are sitting on the porch looking up. And then you've got a bunch of greetings that go with it. And once again, there are dyes that can coordinate with the images. Okay, those are all the 4x6 sets and stamps. Let's do the, the 6x8. These are gonna go quick. I'm gonna zoom out so you can see the whole stamp set. Okay, this first one is called Slimline Florals. These images are designed specifically for the size of a slimline card. So you can stamp these in the center of a slimline card and it's going to fill the space really well. That's great. And there's some greetings in here. You can kind of fill in the frame. And then if you don't want a full frame, you've got just a border right here, which I think could be used on all sorts of different sizes of cards. I think this also, this large frame, I think it'd be cool on like a 5x7 card and it's like, you know, cuts off on one side. I think there's a lot of different things you can do with it. So there's that one. There are dies that cut out the big floral frame and the border. This next one, I cannot wait to do something with this one, is called Flower Garden. Look at all these flowers. Sorry, my lighting's a little bit weird in my temporary craft room. You're getting like double shadows. It's a little hard to see. There we go, that's a little better. You can kind of see the orientation or the stamps there. So, great font down here. This stamp is one that I used in my video that went up yesterday. This is called Happy Meow Thursday. Lots of fun kitties, cat greetings. There are dies that go with it. I won't talk too much about this one since my last video was about it. This is another one that I did for the release. And these are nice big greetings. This is XL Greetings 2. And there are dies for all of the greetings as well. So I love that. All right, here we go. Just a few more things to cover. This is a really big release, you guys. It's crazy. All right, let's talk cling background stamps. Look at this fun one. This is Halftone Circle, I think that's what it's called. Yeah, Halftone Circle. How fun is that? I want to do like a multicolor stamping on this. I think it'd be awesome. This one is just halftone. La la. I love like it. It just looks darker on the one side. It's so cool. This one is called Spring Flowers Background. Nice flowers. I like that the leaves are filled in. Well, some of the leaves are. And then the other ones, you know, just you can color in the blossoms. Awesome. And then this one is really interesting. And at first glance, I'm like, oh, well, I have quite a few stamps like this that have like the words filling in like a texture. But take note of this right edge. The words don't go all the way to the edge. So you could put it on a card and have the card right here, and it looks like these are all staggered. You have that ragged text edge, which is kind of cool. It's a fun background for that. A little bit different. You could also just have it edge to edge, you know, for your regular A2 card. You can have it over here. This one's called Friendship Text Background. Once again, everything's linked down below. I'd appreciate if you do your shopping through all that because I spent a lot of time putting those links together. All right, so now we're gonna do dies and stencils. This one is Mini Stars Party. This is based off the Mini Hearts Party die that I did for, I think it was December. But if you need to cut a ton of stars, this is your die, Mini Star Party. And I believe that is the actual size. See, it's like the same size as what's on the front to the size. Cool. It doesn't cut that outer edge. It only cuts the stars. This one is Mini Slimline Rectangle. So this is going to be all your layers for your mini slimline card. The outer edge cuts the actual card front, I believe. Put that back in there. All right, this one is called Bear Hugs. This is reminiscent of the picture book dies that Simon has been coming out with. So really cute. Let me show you how this die is set up. You have the outer shape of the entire thing, and then you have the individual pieces that cut, so you can piece them together on top of that outline. All right, so that is Bear Hugs. This one is so intricate. Look at this, Garden Gate. And it's actually like a die to create a gatefold card. So go over to the Simons Stamp Store and look at this particular product. There are some examples that other crafters have created. Gorgeous. You can, when it's cut out, it's so intricate and amazing. There's even an example where someone's taken the two gates and they've just used this top portion as an element on a card. Really, really cool. So that one's like a whole cover plate. All right, here's one called Mini Slimline Windows. So it's going to cut some good windows in your slimline card. And we're here. I just saw Marge had a question in the comments. She's asking about my Facebook page. I think it's linked down in the video description below. But if not, there were so many products and I had to cut out some things. So I cut out some links and things like that. If it's not in this video, it will be in one of my other videos. All right, this one is called Sweet Garden Cherry Tree. Oh my word, so many beautiful examples for this as well. Love it. Yes, Kathy, Mini Hearts Die already released. Mini Hearts Party, I think it's called. Okay, this is Mother's Day Flowers. This is one that I designed, and it's meant to cut out, let me show you this. In fact, I can just take these off. All right, so can you picture that? That's like, these actually come off too. Imagine those dots are gone. But basically it's all one big piece, and then you can die cut separate flower colors to go on top of the flowers that are already on the greeting. And then you can cut out the centers for the flowers as well. So you can layer them up, really fun. So this one is just called Mother's Day Flowers. Okay, let's see here. I'm looking at the comments, seeing your questions. Yeah, go look for K Werner Design over at Facebook and it should pop up. All right, this one is Happy Everything from CZ Design, and it's, I'm not sure why it's not in a regular envelope. They didn't send it to me. I'm sure when you guys order it, it will be in a regular envelope, but it cuts the words happy and everything, and you also have the shadow die to go behind it. All right, into the stencils. This, I believe, is called Mini Slimline Patterns. This is also a CZ Design product. And you have stars, dots, and diagonal stripes. And they are sized perfectly to go on your mini slimline card. Yeah, put this back in here so I don't lose any pieces. Okay, this one is called Painted Flowers Wreath. See that wreath design there, super pretty. These last two, this one is called I Like Small Dots, which confuses me because they aren't really small. I would call them more medium, but whatever. They're small compared to the one that's called I Like Big Dots. So this is the I Like Small Dots stencil. It's a I think it's a 6x9. 6x9, yes, it's 6x9. And then this one, I think it's just called Chevron Pattern, and it's large chevron pattern. This is also a 6x9 stencil. All right, there are three woodblock stamps, which is kind of new. Simon hasn't done these before, or maybe they have, but it was like a promotional thing. This is a design that I created a few releases back, well, actually many releases back. It is a die that's just slightly bigger. This stamp was sized down so it would fit on this block, but it's a nice, sturdy red rubber stamp. And then we've got this one right here, which, does it say what it is? Thoughtful Flower. There we go. Looks like a, is that a crocus flower? I'm not entirely sure. And then this one is Outline Butterfly, which I think there was an Outline Butterflies stamp set that had a bunch of different butterflies on it. This is just one of those images from that. So That's almost the entire release. There are some sequin mixes and some envelopes. I'm not going to go through these because I don't have a link down below, but there are some sentiment strips in reverse and with white. And then there's this fun pack of coloring cards from Susie Plantamura. So there we go. That is the release. I hope I didn't forget anything. So I'm thinking I'm going to give you guys three products to choose from for the main design of whatever I create today. And whatever I see most of you mention in the comments, that will be what I create with today. All right, so I'm really loving this. I think we did some fun things with that. So the Happy Mother's Day Flowers die. All right. I also, let's see, what other things do I really want to work with? This one right here, the Flower Garden Stamps. Don't put your vote until you see all three options, right? And I might like throw in some of these other items, you know, like greetings and stuff for whatever I end up doing. And then let's see here. What other item do I want to use? There are so many, you guys. So many different things to create with. Let's see here. How about, yeah, let's play with this. The halftone circle. So tell me which one of those you want to see me create something with today. Halftone flowers or Mother's Day. So we've got a die, a background stamp, and an outline stamp to choose from. I'm just going to sit here and chatter and talk your ears off while you're voting. Let me know which one you want me to create with. And I'm sure whatever I do today, I'll probably bring in some of the other products just to see what's going on. I see a lot of you saying front porch. I'm not going to be using the front porch ones today, mostly because I think I would need a whole lot more planning time, and I don't entirely know what I would do with those quite yet. So I'm not going to be doing the front porch stamps today. So if some of you came in a little bit late, there's a link down below to the new Animal Crossing New Horizons Paper Crafting Community Facebook page. So if any of you want to join my Animal Crossing Facebook page, you're more than welcome. I have had such a good time in Animal Crossing groups online where we all help each other get DIYs and all the different items in the game. And, you know, when someone needs to pay off their house, we help them out with bells. And, you know, so there's some good community aspects to doing things online. All right, I'm seeing some flowers, some halftone flowers. Someone's asking if I've been looking at your cat photos that you're sharing on Facebook. I am. I'm hoping I can start on that different colored cats idea very soon. Mother's Day halftone circle. The only one I designed of these three is this one. These two are by other designers. Flowers, halftone circle, halftone circle. Seeing a few more come in. Alicia, I did not get the new Sanrio cards. My sister has been getting me some of the items though. Okay, let's see. Flowers. I think what I'm seeing most is the flowers. I think that's what I'm seeing most. And I kind of have an interesting idea for how to color these, which could be fun. All right, let's go with the flowers. I'm just going to clean up my space here a little bit because I have products everywhere. And I like to the point where I can't even think. My old craft room had a nice, big, wide open space that I could just push things aside. But I don't really have that option here. I need to keep things fairly put away. All right, so my thought is I'm going to do a picture. I'm going to stamp this first in, I think I'm just going to do regular black ink on white paper. I'm going to use blending tools to blend some color around the main flowers, kind of like a halo of color around each flower. And then I'm going to go in with colored pencils and shade the flowers. So it's going to have like a little bit of a layered coloring look. Once again, this is called Flower Garden. Hey, Kathy Zielski. I see you there in the comments. Is Kathy making funny comments? What color is my nail polish? This nail polish color, it's actually a very, very bright red. Let's see, do I still have my... I don't have my polish still in here because I just painted them this morning. They are actually, let's see, what is it? I think it's from OPI's Hollywood collection. I don't recall what this one's called. I think it's like Emmy something Oscar. I can't remember. All right, got all my blending brushes here. And as far as colors go, I think I'll just grab... I want to use my Concord and Ninth mini cubes, but I cannot even find them anywhere. I don't know where they went, so I might just have to grab my distress inks. Oh, you know what? Let's do Gina K. Let's do Gina K inks today. I can grab my whole tray. Ta-da! There's my whole tray of my Gina K ink cubes. I just wanted something that I could grab all together. So once I'm sitting down, I can just stay there. Okay. All right. I'm scrolling down the comments and trying to catch up. All right, first we're gonna do some stamping and then we'll get to the ink blending. All right, and because I don't know exactly what area of the flower stamp I'm gonna use, I'm just gonna put in like a big, huge piece of paper, right? And then I can cut it apart and use more of it later if I want, right? Okay, I'm grabbing some paper. And I'm gonna cut it down to, let's see, 6.5 by 8.5 will fill my MISTI, so let's do that. See, 6.5. Alrighty. Then I can just slide that right in. Ta-da! Lisa Scott's asking about submitting artwork for stamps and dies. Unfortunately, Simon Says Stamp does not solicit outside artwork like that. Heidi has a group of designers that she works with regularly. So unfortunately, I don't know that just sending artwork without having any sort of relationship would work. Don't quote me on that. But I think that might not work. But anyway. Okay, you guys, let's see. Oh, yes. I didn't say this on YouTube yet. I will be teaching a class. Actually, I'm teaching at the same event that Kathy Zielski is teaching at. we are camp counselors at C9 summer camps. It's put on by Concord at 9th. It's at the end of June over a Friday, Saturday. It is a virtual event. They just opened registration for it yesterday. So go to concordandninth.com and follow links to the event page and sign up. There is early bird pricing through the 29th. So if you want to join us, it's 2 days and 6 different classes. The teachers, wide variety of teachers. Me and Lydia Fiedler will be teaching watercolor. Laura Bassett and Kathy Zielski will be teaching different techniques and things to do with Concord and Ninth turnabout stamps. And Becky Roberts and, oh my word, why am I forgetting who it is? Kathy, who's the other teacher? I actually know them. Why am I? Okay, I'm having to go over to Instagram and look at my own post about it because I'm freaking out that I can't remember. Callie person. Yes. Oh my gosh. Can't believe I forgot. Callie and Becky are teaching like 3D crafts and like putting like 3D, making 3D flowers and things like that. It's going to be really, really fun. I hope you guys can join us. Anyway, I'm going to stamp this in some Versafine. And I'm going to try to get a really good impression in one go because I know the minute I stamp this down, such a big stamp, it's really going to stick to the paper. It might not, but I really kind of anticipate that it will. Making sure I have ink all over that stamp. All right, and then I'm going to use my little glider to make sure I get a really good impression. Okay. Oh yeah, I suspected it really stuck. Ooh, but what a beautiful impression. That turned out great. I don't think I'll need to restamp that at all. Okay. Going to clean off my stamp. I'm down to the very end of my baby wipes and my baby wipes package, and they're getting really dry. So let's hope this cleans off the stamp enough. It's getting some of the ink right. Okay, it's all cleaned up. Now to pull this off the door of my MISTI without breaking a nail. Very carefully, right? Okay, got it. All right, so if any of you are just joining us, I'm using a brand new stamp from Simus Stamp. This is called Flower Garden. And my plan is to do a little bit of ink blending and then colored pencil on top. I think that could be a really interesting combination. Maybe we won't even make it a card today. Maybe it'll just be a bunch of coloring. This is such a large image, it could just be coloring. All right, I'm gonna let this dry just a little bit before I start like smushing things over the top. But I will pick my ink colors. So I wanted to do some ink blending. Turn that one around. Okay, so springtime colors. I think I really want this flower to be like an orangey yellow. So we're gonna go with Tangerine Twist. So we have an orange. We're really gonna need a bright yellow. We already know Wild Dandelion. And like a poppy red, it's called Red Hot. I think I'll do this pink right here. Actually, no, I think I want to do this one, Dusty Rose. This purple will be really pretty, Wild Wisteria. And then I think I'm gonna try to get some of the green leaves. So, Jelly Bean Green. And maybe we want a little pop of blue in there, right? Just a little pop of blue. Actually, I don't even know what flower I would make blue. So maybe I don't use blue. No, well, that's okay. We'll put this one in. It's just a nice pale blue. Powder blue. Actually, I don't want that one. I'm not gonna go with it. I'm not gonna do blue. I'm gonna do a lovely lavender. We'll put in a pale purple. There we go. So very spring colors. I'll set these aside. These are the colors we're working with. Okay. Let me see. See, people are talking about the class. Yeah, internationally, if you are in a time zone that's not convenient, you know, to watch everything live, you could watch it later. I mean, you'd miss the whole interactive aspect of it, but you could still take the class a little bit later, which I think is a great thing that they're offering. Okay, so I'm going to start with Tangerine Twist. And I just want like a really gentle, just a little halo. It's a little strong right there, but that's okay. And I'll do another orange spot. Let's do it right up here. I'm just really letting that be really soft. Okay. Let's do yellow while we're sitting here. Thankfully, I have another small brush that's already being used for yellow. This is Wild Dandelion. And I'm gonna do this flower right here. And this one down here as well. Gonna use Red Hot, and I'm gonna grab a blending brush that already has some red on it. Well, this is pink, but that's okay. Close enough. All right, I think I want like these flowers to be red. Yeah. Just blending into those other colors around it. All right. I think I'll change to Dusty Rose. I'm gonna try to wipe off some of that red so that I only get the pink. And if it has a little bit of red on there, that's totally okay. I'm just gonna come down here. Oh yeah, that's just a little bit of a different tone. It's just a little bit of a different color. Let's see. Small area right there. Any other pinks? Nope, I think that's gonna be it. Okay. Now let's do some purples. We're gonna start with the pale purple, which is Lovely Lavender. And I think I have these little tiny flowers be lavender. Come up here. That purple color going. It's a very pale purple color. It doesn't want to spread. I love where these colors are all together and kind of combining. I love that look. Here's a darker purple called Wild Wisteria. And I'm using Honeybee blender brushes, and they actually have some smaller brushes that probably would work better for all this, but totally okay because I want these colors to sort of halo out and blend in with each other. So it sort of lends itself to that whole idea anyway. So sorry, my whole table's shaking. All right, we've got a at least one more of this. We might have to pick a couple other colors or maybe put more of that pink in. Oh, I love that purple. That purple looks awesome. All right, and then I'm just gonna add some spots of green. And thankfully I have a really itty bitty brush that I've been using green with. Actually, I wanna do something with that flower. I feel like that would be a good spot for more yellow, maybe. No, we're gonna do pink. Do a little bit of pink right there. Or a lot of pink. A lot of pink. And there's one flower down here in this corner, so we'll get that one too. And one over here. I think that's all of the main flowers now, right? So then I'm coming back to jelly bean green. And I can just get some green areas. Like all through here is all leaves. I don't know if I'll be able to hit every single little grouping of leaves, but I'll do what I can. In fact, you know what? If you wanted to stop after all this ink blending, I think you could. But I'm gonna come back in and do a little bit of shading using colored pencils. I think it's gonna look really, really cool. Adding just a little bit of detail and dimension on these flowers. I think it's gonna give them a very finished look. Okay. Almost looks like it's spray painted, right? All right, let's zoom in here. And we can do some, you know what? I don't know if I dare, but I kind of want some green right here. Might just go a little brownish. That's okay. It went a little brown, but that's okay. So I've got my colored pencils here. Ta-da! These are Polychromos colored pencils, and I'm going to start doing some shading. Let's start with, well, before I do anything, because I want to make sure these inks don't smudge, I'm going to take just a piece of paper, and I'm going to be laying it down so that my hand can rest on it. I'm just afraid that since these inks aren't completely dry yet, that they might smear or smudge. I'm going to take a darker purple, like a violet red shade. This is magenta, but I'm gonna come in here and I'm just gonna be adding a little bit of shading on this flower. And I apologize for the table shake. You can envision a flower that the darkest shaded areas would be in the interior. So that's where I'm adding the most shading. Right down in there. That's where the darkest color would be. And then just lightening up on the shading as I come up. And you know what? I think this could go even darker. So I'm gonna find a brown. And in those darkest areas, Kathy Rakusin calls them the nooks and crannies. Just add a little bit of that darkest color in the nooks and crannies, and that'll give your coloring a boost. All right, so you can see how that flower stands out from everything else because it's the only thing shaded so far. So here we go, let's do some more shading. Since I've got my colors out for this one, I'm gonna try to not shake the table. I don't know how well that's gonna work. Maybe if I lean against it, it'll give it some stability. Adding more shading down those areas. I'm going to switch back to that dark purple just because I liked the kind of color it gave. And I'm not going to get too fussy with it. We'll just stop right there. I'm going to use the same colors for these other two of the same flowers. I used a pink ink for that blending. So these are going to look just a little bit different than the red ones. Doing very simple shading on these. All right, let's do the yellow flowers now. I think I'll take this kind of ochre shade. This is... oh, burnt or ochre. It's exactly what I thought it was. I'm just add a little bit of shading on the yellow petals. For those that are just joining, I've stamped a large floral image from Simus's Stamp in black ink. I ink blended over the top with blender brushes just to add some highlights of color over different flowers and different leaves. And now I'm going in and doing some more detailed shading on each flower so that it helps each flower stand out. I'm gonna grab a different shade. This is Sanguine, a little more of an orangey color, and I'm just going to try to get a little more of an orange center for my yellow flower. While I've got this color out, I'll go ahead and do this other one as well. Seriously, I could probably be here for 2 hours, like painstakingly shading all of these, but I'm gonna try to speed up and have it be a little quicker just for the sake of the live stream, because I don't want you guys having to hang out forever. I mean, we're already nearly 45 minutes in, so. Just adding a little bit of color. Okay, for the orange flowers, this one, I think I'm gonna come in with like a bright red. And I'll start doing the shading with that. It's not realistic, but that's okay because what about this picture is actually realistic, right? I think I am going to give this daisy-like flower a much darker center. I come in with a brown shade. just fill that in. And I'm even going to grab a little bit of black and just darken up the area right below. Like right where it meets the petals, I'm darkening that up. I've got another one of those flowers up here. I'll do the same thing. Just adding a little bit of this red color to the petals. Give it a little bit of color variation. Trying to not be too picky. I can start to be really picky on these things, and then it takes 10 years. So I'm trying not to be. All right, bringing in this dark brown. And then the black. Just giving a little bit of dimension to that. Okay, here we are. Moving right along. Let's do the small purple-ish flowers. I'm going to come in with, this color looks good. Kind of random, it's mauve, or some people say mauve. I always say mauve. And to me, this is not a mauve, this is purple. Mauve to me is more like a mauve that you would have for lipstick, kind of almost like a dusty rose. That's more of what mauve is to me. But isn't it funny how some people, like, the color name is so different. Did you know that chartreuse, some people think that's a pink color? I've always heard of chartreuse as more of like a bright kind of olivey green shade. But for some people, chartreuse is pink. That's crazy. And some of you out there watching might be like, yeah, it's like a pink shade. So let me know in the comments, chartreuse, what color is that for you? I don't know how they can call this mauve. This is not mauve. This is purple. This is not mauve. I know Faber-Castell, I believe they are a German brand. They might, I think they are. So maybe just, it's like a color translation. Yeah, yellowy green, olivey green. We do have people who think it's pink. Oh my gosh, Alicia and Megan. I don't think it's can be specifically colorblind people, because people who are not colorblind have learned that chartreuse is a pink shade as well. Isn't that funny? In French, mauve means purple. Oh, well, that makes sense then. Here I am, like, getting all upset over them calling it something different. But you know what? You know, that's what I was saying. Language is probably an issue here. Mauve to me is a light purple. Yeah, I like, it's like a purpley, light purpley red, like a dusty purpley red. That's what it is to me. I don't know, it's crazy. When people, when colors have like names beyond just the regular color names, throws me off. Okay, let's do another flower here. Let's do these purple ones, and I'm going to pick a different purple shade. This one is called Delft Blue. And I'm okay with having that be more of a bluish violet, because I really just want to shade this in. Sorry for blocking the light so much. Let's see if I can get this so I'm not blocking so much light. I feel like I need someone to go over and Google chartreuse and let us know. In fact, you know what? I'm going to do it. I'm just going to Google it. I've got my phone right here. I'm just going to Google chartreuse color. Okay, according to Google, it is that like bright yellow green that I'm thinking of. Is chartreuse red or green? Let's see. According to theparisreview.com, I have no idea what authority they have over color names, but it says chartreuse refers only to the acidic green. There never has been a red chartreuse, but for whatever reason, hordes of people hold dear their memories of this alternate color. For some, it is nearer to magenta. For others, it's a brick red. Interesting. I don't know. I think for the majority of the world, chartreuse is this bright yellowy, olivey green. Not quite olive. That makes it look too dark. But yeah. Yeah, getting lots of green. Chartreuse color pink. Let's see what it says. Why do people think that chartreuse is pink? That is a good color. Yeah, I don't know. You know what? Maybe it's because of examples like this. It's absolutely beautiful with those pink shades. You know, like if someone said, oh, that's chartreuse, I'd be like, oh, it's that pink shade, but it's not. it's the bright yellow green. Yeah, isn't that weird? I think I heard about that a while back and I was like, no way. But it's also one of those colors that, I mean, I'm sure some children learn what chartreuse is when they're quite young, but I didn't really know until I was much older because I'd never really heard that color descriptive word. You know, I just hadn't encountered it. Doing very simple shading, just adding a little bit of color right at the base of each one of these segments. Not adding a ton on those, but it is adding quite a bit to the picture. All right, these are pink, so I'm going to, I'm thinking maybe like a darker red. This is Matter, and I'll just come up here and add a little bit of shading just to give it some dimension. And same for the little guys. I think where the bulk of the shading is going to come in is when I add a little bit of shading to the leaves. And we're almost done. Okay, I'm gonna pick kind of this green looks good. What is this? Chromium green opaque. Okay. I'm just gonna add some green onto these areas. I feel like my hand is blocking a lot of the light. I apologize. By adding just a little bit of shading on each one of these sections, it helps differentiate it from the ink blending around it. This is a very similar concept to some watercolor projects I've done recently, where I do an underlay, like an underpainting of color, which in this case would be considered the ink blending, just to lay out some large blended areas of color, and then go back in and add detail coloring on top. It's a very similar concept, and I think it's a really amazing look and really easy. It gives you a very sophisticated look without much effort at all. You know what I think would make this look even more awesome? White dots with a white gel pen. So we're going to add that here in a minute, because I think that's really going to make some of the flowers pop and give it some awesome detail. Like these little, right there. As you can see, I'm not being too fussy with the leaves. I'm just adding enough color at the base of each leaf to give it a kind of a base. And then I move right on. I'm also to the point where I'm like, I've been coloring this for a long time. I kind of want to just be done. But it's so close, I don't want to give up. So I'm keeping it very simple. All right, I just saw something that I want to do specifically on these small flowers. It has a center. I want to come in with a really bright yellow. Actually, you know what? I'll do that with the white. Never mind. Okay. Looking for my white gel pen. And let's zoom out so we can see the whole thing too. So here's our entire flower image, our little flower garden. And I'm going to add the white gel pen dot definitely in like little areas like that. Center of the purple flowers. I have to be really careful where I place my hand now. All right, I think I got all those areas, but I'm gonna add some additional little dots. Like I kind of want to add them on the sides here. And is that all I want? I like how bright those dots are. I don't want to overdo it, you know? I just saw something that needs to be fixed. I don't remember if this was the green I was using or not, but that's okay. I just need to add a little green right there. That's definitely not the green I was using. Oh well. Okay. Do I want to add more? Or do I want to just leave it at that? I think I kind of want to just leave it right there. I don't think I want to add any more white. I think it might distract. All right, so that is the picture for today. I think I might be able to turn this into two cards, maybe even three, depending on what I do, right? I hope this gives you guys some ideas and something to do with coloring, like mixing ink blending with colored pencils. I think you could also do ink blending with Copic markers. But if you're, in fact, I think this ink is, well, I'm not sure about Gina's. I know for sure Simon says stamp ink is Copic friendly and waterproof. So you could use the Simwiss's stamp inks to do the ink blending and then do your Copic marker coloring right over top. Just make sure you stamp the black with the Copic friendly ink. I think that could be really pretty. And Copic markers would give you the opportunity to get lots of, you know, really awesome shading in there. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. And make sure you check out the new Animal Crossing paper crafting community over at Facebook. The link is down below. I have all the memberships on approval right now, but I'll try to approve everyone as fast as possible. And thank you so much for joining me today. All the links to all the products I showed at the very beginning of the video are down below. The inks and the ink blending tools and things like that that I used for the actual demonstration, I'll add those as well as soon as I'm done here, as I'm done with the live stream. Thank you so much for joining me. Just a reminder that the C9 Summer Camp early bird registration, that price lasts until the 29th, like through the 29th of March. So just a few more days. And please join us for 2 days online for that event in June. I think it's going to be really fun. I'll tell you guys more about it as it gets closer. Thanks for watching today. I will see you guys on Monday for a new video. Hopefully Monday. It might be Tuesday, but I'm hoping for Monday. Thanks for watching.